The conditional formatting feature in Excel allows you to automatically change the format of a cell depending on certain criteria. So for example, if a number is bigger than 100, it'll be bold or put in red. In this segment, you'll learn how to find and activate the feature and how to set up the criteria to change the formats of a cell. The easiest way to show how to use conditional formatting is to use an example. For simple conditional formatting, we have got the following example. A couple of ratios based on various departments in the company. And what would be nice is if we could somehow change the formats of these cells to show which departments and divisions are doing well, which are doing less well, and which are doing poorly. Using conditional formatting, this can be done. So for example, you highlight the cells you want to apply the conditional formatting to. You go to Format, Conditional Formatting, and this is available in the more recent versions of Excel from about 1997. This box will pop up, and what it first says is this is condition number one. Here you can choose whether the cell value is specific or is a formula. For this simplified version, we're going to use the cell value, and then you can choose what it must look at in the criteria. So must the numbers in the cells be between two numbers, not between, equal to, not equal to, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. So in this situation, what we're going to say is, if the cell value is less than or equal to 10%, then you click on the format and you've got the choice to format your cells. You can either format the characters, or you can change the border in some way, or the contents of the cell. And in this case, if it's less than 10%, we're going to make it red. Click OK. We then want to add another criteria. And here we want to say again, the cell value. This time what we want to say is, if it's between this 10% and 20%, that's in the middle ground. So we'll leave it on between, and we'll say between 10% and 20%. And in this case, we're going to format it and we'll make it yellow. Push OK. And you can add one more condition with conditional formatting. And in this case, what we're going to say is, if the cell value greater than or equal to 20%, then what we're, it's quite a good result, and we'll make it green. Now you've set up all your conditions. As long as you've highlighted the cells that are looking at, you push OK, and you'll see that automatically the cells are changed to the color. So you can quickly look and see that JHB and CT did well, BLM and DBN are so-so, and PE is bad. If it turns out that DBN actually had a percentage of 31, when you input the number, you see it automatically changes to adapt for the new input. You can use conditional formatting for more sophisticated criteria. For example, here we have a net profit after tax figure, and we have some benchmarks here. So the company has decided that 8% is the benchmark. And what we would like is for the colors, the cell colors, to change depending on whether the net profit after tax is above or below this percentage. Obviously, we can go and use simple conditional formatting and type in the 8%. The problem is that if these benchmarks change, you're going to have to work through the entire spreadsheet and make changes to all these percentages. What you can do, however, is you highlight the cells that you want to apply the conditional formatting to. You click Format, Conditional Formatting. Because we're using the more sophisticated methodology, we're not going to say the cell value is a number. We're now going to say the formula is. And what you do is you then say equals, and you be specific. You want to say if this cell is bigger than that cell over there. Now, what's important to realize here, you can see absolute referencing has been put in here, which means that this criteria is going to be anchored. Because you've highlighted a selection of cells, if you chose a format and then pushed OK, what would happen is Excel would say this exact formula with the absolute referencing must be included in all these cells. So if it is left as is, for example, this cell won't use itself, but will actually refer to B14 because that is what the formula says. So what you need to do is you need to say, okay, that is the cell I've chosen for this number. For the rest of them, I want them to use their own cells. So it needs to be a relative referencing. So we'll come here and we'll remove the absolute referencing. We're asking it to be, is it bigger than B7? In this case, all these cells need to refer to the absolute reference. They need to refer to this cell here. So in this case, the absolute reference is correct. You can now set up the format. I'll make it green and bold. Click OK. You can add other criteria. We're going to say OK. What happens now is Excel has gone at looked at the cell, compared it to B7, said it's bigger, it's made it green and bold. Gone to this cell, looked at this cell, compared it, made it green and bolded it. So now, if for example you change this to 6%, what will happen is it automatically corrects itself. But more importantly, if for whatever reason the benchmarks change, so let's say this goes up to 11%, that also directly affects the spreadsheet. Another good way to use the sophisticated conditional formatting is to actually find what criteria, where the criteria is met. So for example, I'm just going to make this a bit smaller. Let's say we want to know who the worst is. In this case, in order for the operating expenses to revenue, the highest is the worst. So we put a max function, which will tell us the division with the highest percentage. Now, this is a particularly small spreadsheet, but on bigger ones, it might be useful if the cell that has that number is highlighted so you can easily get it. With conditional formatting, this is as simple as highlighting the cells. Click Format, Conditional Format. Okay, and this is not a number issue, this is a referencing issue, so it's a formula. We click equals, we click in the white cell of the highlighted cells. Because we know it needs to be applied all the way across, we know that this cannot be an absolute reference, it needs to be a relative reference. So we get rid of that. And we say if that is equal to the cell, and again, even though it's moving across, we now know it needs to be anchored there, so that's an absolute reference, so we're happy with the dollar signs. The format we want is red to indicate the problem department. Click OK. We click OK. And what happens is it points out which one is the worst based on this formula. So if it turns out that we actually have 27% there, it will move across and highlight the department that has that highest value. Using conditional formatting, your spreadsheet can become quite colorful, and you may decide that you want to remove one or all of the conditional formats. The way to do this is you highlight the cells that have conditional formatting on them. You go Format, Conditional Formatting, and there's a delete button here. You click the delete button, and it will ask you what conditions do you want to delete. Now we've highlighted the whole area, and we want to delete all three conditions, but you can maybe highlight a cell and just remove one or two conditions. We click OK, and OK again. You see that all the conditional formats have been removed. Sometimes it's difficult to find the conditional formats. For that, I recommend you use the go-to special command, and there is some training available on the site.